All right, I was hoping to play through the entire thing so I could give you a complete overview before I gave my first impressions or my review or whatever. I was really aiming to do that, but unfortunately, I'm really tired and I just didn't feel like playing anymore, so I had to stop the stream. So, what do I think of Princess Peach Showtime? What is this game doing for me? Needless to say, it is, I think, the best game released so far this year. It is visually interesting, great gameplay mechanics, it has a lot of variety, it's a lot of fun to play, great music, lots of interesting set pieces. It does not feel repetitive. You do get to see the costumes reused in certain situations, and they have like more than one level, and they are pretty distinct from each other. Not only are the costumes completely unique, the levels you get with the follow-ups are usually completely different than what you get before, right? You get the sword fighter in a spooky castle, and you get like the cowgirl going after a train, instead of just raiding a town and fighting some guy. Like, you get a lot of variety. There is no denying it at this point. Princess Peach Showtime is a phenomenal Nintendo game. Now, right now, by the looks of it, people are like in denial about that. People are trying to like do that thing they always do where they pretend that like, oh, this isn't a major Nintendo release, just like they did with Mario Wonder, just like they did with Tears of the Kingdom, just like they did with Fire Emblem Engage, Bayonetta 3, No More Heroes 3, Shin Megami Tensei 5. Like, the list goes on and on and on and on, right? Like, this is the common pattern for the Switch. Is that a new game comes out, it's excellent, it has a lot of fans, it does really well, it's really popular, but people like come out in droves trying to tell you that like, oh, I'm not interested in that. Oh, this game is too easy. Oh, this game doesn't have enough story. Oh, this game does this. Oh, this game doesn't do that. It's not as good as other games. And what I ask of you when it comes to Princess Peach Showtime specifically, what do you play that's like this? Like, what in the Princess Peach Showtime genre, like the kind of variety platformer kind of like action game kind of thing, like, what are you playing like this on other platforms, on other from other developers, from other creators? Like, there's nothing quite like this, right? Like, I think a lot of people just don't really appreciate the value of what Princess Peach Showtime is offering, right? Because like, you're getting a lot of interesting level designs, you're getting a lot of interesting costumes, you're getting like really good boss fights. And overall, like, I am very, 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 very pleased with what I've seen from Princess Peach Showtime. Is it perfect? No, I do think that like the length is a problem. And I do think I kind of wish it was a little bit more difficult. But like, I do think in that regard, it's very similar to like Kirby in that way, where like, yeah, like it's not the hardest game ever, but like the artistry and the animations and like the presentation and like how much fun the game is kind of like overtakes all that, right? It's very possible by the time I finish it, when I have time, when I get over this like fatigue that I'm feeling right now, when I have time to sit down and play through this game again, like I'll have like, have completely just. I'll be completely talking about like I'll completely flip on that and talk about how the game has like the perfect amount of challenge. Right now, I can kind of see that like, maybe it's too short. Maybe the levels could be more elaborate. Maybe they could have been more complicated, right? That's kind of my feelings at the moment, but I'm also having like a lot of fun. I'm probably about like halfway through the game now by my estimations, if my calculations are correct. And I have just been having nonstop fun the entire time. Each new costume is interesting and engaging. The mechanics are fresh and original. Each area, not just each level, each area in the levels are like really visually distinct and interesting and have a lot going on. And I just don't see how anybody could look at what this game is offering and try to say that like it looks bad or disappointing. Right. I have seen people come out and like try to complain about the frame rate. It's fine. I've seen people complain about like the simplicity of the gameplay. It's fine. I've seen people complain about like just all sorts of things, and none of it has held water. Right. Now that I've put like a couple of hours in the game, like three, I think, I can tell you that the game is just top-notch, high quality, just all in all, just like a fantastic experience, right? This is a game that I think is going to be a cult classic. You know, much like something like Conker's Bad Fur Day or Wario Land Shake It, right? It's going to be one of those games that people look back fondly on, like 15 years later, and just be like, wow, that game was really innovative and fun, right? It's one of those titles, right? And I'm very tired of seeing games like this come out and just being dismissed by the community, right? Like leading up to launch, like I heard a lot of people like just make up a lot of nonsense about this game, like, oh, I'm not interested in it. Oh, it's just a mini game collection. Oh, is she gonna get kidnapped by Bowser? You know, you've seen people like I've seen people legit like argue whether or not it's woke, whether or not it's too like whether or not it's pandering too much to gamers, right? Like I've seen people like argue like woke versus anti-woke with this game, like it's somehow both woke and anti-woke, right? It's one of those things where you're just like it does really feel as if the vast majority of the audience really wanted this game to fail. Really wanted there to be some kind of major controversy attached to it. And now that I've played it, I can safely say there's like nothing like that, right? The game impressed me with its decisions, with what it's managed to do, with how it's managed to be fun and original, unlike anything else I've ever played. This is absolutely one of the best games I've played so far this year. You know, better than Unicorn Overlord, better than Another Code R, better than Mario vs. DK, better than everything else, right? Like this is a game that really kind of shocked me at with how good it is. I really wish I could have sat down and finished the entire thing on stream, but as it so happens, I really need to take a break. So it's from playing games. So it's just one of those evenings, unfortunately. But when I look back on when I look at what gamers have said about this one, have tried to push, like none of those excuses really hold water, right? Like here I am, someone who loves Princess Peach, loves Mario, loves Nintendo, playing this game, and I'm telling you, this is a top-notch Nintendo game. I'm telling you that Good Feel is like one of Nintendo's better developers. I'm partners. I'm telling you that this game is good, and yet. Are people like going to listen to me, or are they going to like just throw their hands up in the air and keep pretending that the Switch 2 is going to be out by the end of the year? Like this is one of those situations I think where a perfectly good video game is being ignored for selfish, ignorant reasons by a stupid, lazy audience.